अस्सलाम वालेकुम एवरीवन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड सेफ एट योर होम्स. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव क्वेश्चन नंबर 14. दिस इज़ योर क्वेश्चन नंबर 14 ऑफ एक्सरसाइज 2D एंड पेज नंबर 053. ओके, सो आई एम गोना डू पार्ट बी एंड डी. ओके, सो कम टू द पार्ट डी फर्स्ट. राइट, सो वी हैव माइनस 0.2 रेज टू पावर 3 मल्टीप्लाई 27 ओवर 1.6 प्लस 0.105. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, यू कैन सी दैट इन दिस क्वेश्चन वी हैव टू ऑपरेशंस. ओके, सो वी हैव टू अप्लाई टू ऑपरेशंस. द फर्स्ट वन इज मल्टीप्लीकेशन एंड द सेकेंड वन इज एडिशन. ओके, सो फर्स्ट वी विल सॉल्व द ब्रैकेट. ऑलराइट, फर्स्ट वी विल सॉल्व दिस पावर. ऑलराइट, सो यू कैन सी दैट यू हैव अ क्यूबिक पावर. सो वी विल मल्टीप्लाई दिस नंबर 3 times and then we will get the simple decimal number. All right, then we will multiply it with this fraction and then we will add them. All right, so let's see, come to the solution. Okay students, you can see that we have question number, sorry, D part of question number 14. All right, come to the solution. All right, okay, first we will solve this bracket. All right, you can see that we have a decimal minus 0.2 power 3. So we will, what does it mean? We will multiply this 0.2 3 times. All right, what will we do? We will multiply this 0.2 3 times. All right, how? First we will multiply it like this, 0.2 into 0.2. so you can do it in your rough work like this. 0.2 into 0.2, 2 twos are 4, 2 zeros are 0, then 0 twos are 0, 0 zeros are 0. All right, so when you will add them, you will get the answer, that is 004. And now you know that how can we solve them and how can we put decimal by decimal places method. All right, you can see that in this number we have 1 dp, so we will write it like this. Another, we have 1 dp, so we will add the dps. It has 1 dp, it has 1 dp. All right, so we will add them. 1 plus 1 is equals to 2 dp. So we have to put decimal after 2 digits. So that is why we will put it like this. 0.04 is the answer when we just multiplied it 2 times. But we have to multiply it, but we have to multiply it by 3 times. Alright. So we will get this answer. We will multiply 0.2 again with this, by this answer. Alright, so it will be 2 4s are 8, 2 0s are 0, 2 0s are 0. Alright, you can see that. In this way, we will just multiply it. We will get the answer, that is 0008 basically. All right. Again, we will count the dp. This is 2 dp. This is 1 dp. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So we will put point after 3 digits. 1, 2, 3. So the answer is 0.008. Okay. You will write it like this. You will just write it, because when we will solve it, we will get the answer, that is 0.008. all right, okay, next what will we do for this? All right, we have to change this decimal number into a simple whole number or simple integer. All right, so what will we do? Okay, in the we don't have any point in the numerator. In the numerator we have simple whole number, or you can say that the integer. All right, so but we need to change this decimal number into a whole number. So we can do it like this, that we will put multiply 10 in the numerator, multiply 10 in the multiply 10 in the denominator. All right, we will multiply 10 in the numerator, multiply 10 in the denominator. All right, so when you will multiply this 27 multiply 10 will be 270, and then you will shift this point after 6, so it will be 16. All right, okay, next you will write 0.105 as it is. All right, okay students, next what will you do? You can see that we have 270 over 16 and they both are even numbers, so we can cut them. So 2 8s are 16, 2 1s are 2, 2 3s are 6, and 2 5s are 10. When you will divide 270 by 2, you will get the answer, that is 135. Okay, again we can cut them. How? 8 1s are 8 and 8 0.001. how? We will just divide it. Okay, so you can divide it like this, 0.008 divided by 8. Okay, okay students, as this is so obvious, this is so obvious, whenever you have any zeros before any digit. All right, so what you have to do, you will just write it like this. You will write all these digits and point over there, 0.00. but if it is difficult for you, So you can divide it like this. 8 zeros are 0. 0 remainder, again we will put this point over there. Then again 8 zeros are 0. Remainder 0. Then we will just write this 0 over there. Then 8 zeros are 0. Again this, we are left with 8. So 8 ones are 8. So our answer is 0.001. Or simply you can divide it and then you will get the answer, that is 0.001. Alright. Okay, so 8 ones are 8, and 8, when you will just divide this 8 by 0.008, you will get this answer, 0.001. Alright. Okay. Next, you are left with minus 0.001 multiply 135 plus 0.105. So students, you will just multiply it by 135. So you will multiply it like this. You will count the TPs and then you will put 0. Okay students, the answer is 000.135. So we only need 10. Alright. So there is no need that we have to write all these zeros, because you can see that whenever we get the answer, it can be 0.135 or 0.135. It's up to you. You can write it. If you will write it like this, 0.135, that's very okay. Okay. So we will write 0.135. I just wrote 10 before point. All right. So we will add it. You can see that we have 0.135. This is minus 0.135 plus 0.105. All right. So plus minus is minus. So we will subtract it. We will subtract it like this. 5 minus 5, 0. 3 minus 0, 3. 1 minus 1, 0. All right. So 0 minus 0, 0. All right. So the answer is 0.030. Okay. 0.030. Okay, students. You can write 0.030, or if you don't want to write this 0, this is not a big deal, okay? So you can write it like this. So minus 0.03 is your answer. Okay, come to the part A. Okay, students, you can see that our part A is 0.15 over 0.5 multiply bracket minus 0.16 over 1.2. And you know that, students, you can cut the numbers vertically or by cross multiplication. Or so this is cross. When you will just write that, when you will join this 0.5 with 0.16 and 0.15 to 1.2, it will be look like a cross. All right, so you can cut your numbers in this way or in this way. Okay, so come to the solution. Okay students, our first fraction is 0.15 over 0.5. Okay, so first we need to change this decimal number into a simple number or integers or whole numbers, whatever you want to say. Okay, so okay students, there is no need that in every step you have to write multiply 10, multiply 10. You can just do it in your rough work and then you will write your answers straightforward. All right, so look at this. What is the method? Basically, how can you shift the point? Because you need to multiply 10 in the numerator as well as in the denominator. Okay, so we will do it in our rough walk. It will be look like this. 0.15 into 2, 0.5 into, sorry, this is not 2, this is 10. 0.15 into 10, 0.5 into 10. All right, so we will just shift this point after one digit because we have a 10. So it will be 1.5 and this will be 5. Okay, so we are left with 1.5 over 5 and I just wrote it like this. Okay, I just did it in rough work. Okay, so multiply 0.16 over 1.2. Okay students, now you can see that in the numerator we have a decimal number, but in the denominator we are done with decimal number. We have a whole number or integer or whatever you can say. This is a positive number. Okay, so now I will just use that method for 1.5 over 1.2 because we can cut them. This means that we have this is division. Basically 1.5 is divided by 5 as well as 1.5 is divided by 1.2. okay, so I'm gonna just put 10 for 1.5 over 1.2. okay, so we have 1.5 into 10 and 1.2 into 10, and we will just shift this point over there. We are left with 15 over 12. So you can do it like this. You can do it in this direction, like vertically and by cross. Okay, so I will write it like this. I just did it in my rough work. Okay, so you are left with 15 over 5 minus 0.16 over 12. Now you can cut the numbers. 5 ones are 5, 5 threes are 15. Okay, and then when you have 3 multiply minus 0.16 over 12, you can cut them like this. 3 ones are 3, 3 fours are 12. All right, so you are left with minus 0.16 over 4. Now you need to divide it. You will divide it like this. You 0.16 over divided by 5, so you can write it like this. Okay, 4 zeros are 0, and then 1, because you know that the remainder is less than 0, so we need another number. So if we will write up here, we have to put the 0 in the answer. Okay, that is why we just put this 0. Okay, so for 4 is a 16, so the answer is 0.004. Basically, your answer is minus 0.004. Okay, students, part B and part D, you will do it their parts yourself, all right? Okay, I hope it is clear. Okay, students, take care and Allah Hafiz.